In business, the Philippines and Thailand will be left behind as other economies in Asia recover from the COVID-19 pandemic. An economist for Japanese investment bank Nomura said both countries are unlikely to return to pre-COVID levels until late 2022. He explained Manila's slow recovery is due to its sluggish vaccination rollout and small stimulus packages. He added the time window to pass more stimulus measures has closed, with Congress in recess until late July.
I think what's non-negotiable for the government is to push infrastructure spending to try and drive the recovery. I think infrastructure spending will pick up in the second half of the year, also because there's an added incentive. We have an elections, presidential election coming next year. The year prior to the election, particularly in the second half of that year, this is where you tend to get outside spending on capital outlays of the government. So we think this year is no exception. So that's going to drive or help the recovery somewhat.
Nomura expects the Philippine economy to grow 5.5% this year, lower than government's 6-7% target.
Philippine inflation eases to its lowest level yet this year, mainly driven by lower transport costs. But as Juan de Guzman tells us, the consumer price index is still far higher compared to pre-pandemic levels.
Data from the Philippine Statistics Authority show inflation slowed to its lowest level yet this year in June, thanks in part to a slowdown in transport inflation. National statistician Undersecretary Dennis Mapa, however, notes this can be attributed to a high base effect, as transport prices shot up in June 2020 due to the effects of quarantine policies on public transport. In other words, the increase in transport prices has slowed, but the cost of things like tricycle fare remains high, especially when compared to pre-pandemic levels. Mapa says he doesn't know if transport inflation can slow further because fuel prices have been rising.
Also, dahil pumapasok naman yung fuel dito sa ating mataas din na weight, particularly yung LPG, isa pa rin yun, no? So pag may spike sa fuel products, for example, mayroon siyang spillover effects dito sa housing, water, electricity, gas, and other fuels.
Mapa says food prices could again be a problem moving forward, with fish inflation accelerating and meat inflation remaining elevated due to the lingering effects of the African swine fever. Based on the price monitoring of the Department of Agriculture, fish prices have actually remained stable over the last 3 weeks. However, the DA managed to find some wet markets charging slightly higher prices. Tilapia, for example, saw the bottom of its price range rise by 10 pesos during the last week of June. Pork prices have also been steady, but some wet markets have also been offering steadily lower prices of liempo, or pork belly.
Nakikita natin ano yung effect ng importation, although I'm not so sure no kung dumating na yung malaking bahagi nito. Pero ang nakita namin sa ating mga datos ay bumaba ang inflation ng meat products, particularly ang pork no sa buong bansa at particular dito sa National Capital Region. Sa National Capital Region, for example, between 8 pesos to 10 pesos yung drop ng prices of pork in particular no compared to May. Ito itatrack namin kung tutuloy ito dahil malaki rin yung weight ng ating meat components sa food basket.
Philippine Central Bank Governor Benjamin Jokno says inflation will likely remain at the high end of the target range of 2-4% this year, and the effective implementation of non-monetary measures such as the importation of pork will be crucial in mitigating supply problems. Socio-Economic Planning Secretary Carl Chua says the importation program is only temporary and they will continue programs aimed at improving domestic production. Economist Michael Ricafort of RCBC says inflation may have already peaked in February as the impact of government interventions to boost supply will continue to be felt in the months ahead. However, he warns the Philippine peso has been weakening against the U.S. dollar, and this is effectively making all imports, whether it be food or fuel, more expensive. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.